Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, verily, we have sent to every nation a messenger, so that this messenger conveys worship Allah alone and disbelieve in all false, made up, innovated gods. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said the meaning, verily, whomever obeys Allah and His messenger will attain success. Success can only be obtained by worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following the greatest man, the final messenger, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O you who believe, fear Allah, abstain from whatever is haram, establish whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you. Fear Allah, the fear that He deserves, and only die in state of total submission. Total submission to Allah and to Allah alone. If we were to look at the biography of those that are righteous, we would find that they have something in them which is called yaqeen, certainty in Allah, certainty in the Day of Judgment, certainty in Jannah, certainty in the fire. They have certainty, and we lack this. Many of us, especially in this day and age, they have doubts about Allah. They have doubts about Jannah. They have doubts about hell. They have doubts about the Quran. They have doubts about Islam. Wallah, there are some Muslims, few in numbers, we have to convince them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He exists. We have to convince them that the Quran, it is perfect and unique and free from all wal'iyadu billah false. Dear brothers, it is compulsory upon us to convey this message to our kids that Islam is the religion of Allah. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the best deeds to Allah is belief that you have no doubt about. You have no doubt about. You actually believe in it 100%. Allah has said subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily, the religion of Allah is al-Islam. In another verse, Allah has said subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whomever takes a religion besides Islam, Allah will not accept it from them. And in the hereafter, there'll be those that are losers. Na'am ayyuhal ikhwa. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu has said, patience is half of the faith, but certainty, it is all the faith. A sister approached me, a Muslimah, but she doubts Allah. Yani her background, her parents are Muslims. She doubts the existence of the Creator. Allah has said subhanahu wa ta'ala, is there doubts about Allah? And He's the Creator of the heavens and the earth? Subhanallah. Some of us, their faith becomes stronger when they see the name of Allah on an apple or an orange or a potato. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me and you, respected brother, to reflect, to ponder. يقول ربنا عز وجل إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Allah has said subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily, in the creations of the heavens and the earth and the rotation of the day and night, there are signs to those who consider. إخواني الكرام أتدرون أن هذا الدين ينتشر في كل مكان ووالله لو دين حرب مثل هذا الدين ما بقي منه أثر. Did you know this religion of Islam is the fastest growing religion in the world today? In this day and age, technology exists. Access to information, it's never been easier. It's the fastest growing religion in the world because it makes sense to those who have sense. And if any religion has been fought like Islam, wallahi, you would not see a trace of it. Congratulations to those who have certainty. They have certainty in Allah. They have certainty in everything that Allah has mentioned in the Quran and whatever the Prophet ﷺ has said. And by Allah, when you have certainty, your status will be lifted. You'll move from Islam to Iman. The majority of us are Muslims. Not many of us are mu'mins. That's the fact of the matter. Because once we reach this level of Iman, we will go into Jannah. Jannah? Yes, Jannah, in this life. يقول أحد العلماء إن في الدنيا جنة من لم يدخلها لم يدخل جنة الآخرة. One of the ulama has summed it up in a beautiful manner, saying that in this life there is paradise. If you don't enter into the paradise of this life, you will not enter into the paradise of the hereafter. إخوان الكرام كان نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لبلال أرحنا بها يا بلال. الراحة في الصلاة. الراحة في الصلاة. الطمأنينة بالتعبد إلى الله عز وجل. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say to Bilal, O Bilal, allow us to rest by prayer. Allow us to feel a sense of tranquility, a sense of security through prayer. Through prayer. أكثرنا يريد أن يرتاح من الصلاة. Many of us would say to the Imam, please, ya Allah, let's pray quickly. They used to rest via prayer. The Prophet ﷺ has said, three things, if they're in you, you will taste the sweetness of faith. Yes, faith has sweetness. Once you come into the deen properly, then you'll taste sweetness. Subhanallah, ayyuhal ikhwa. Allah has said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there are people that worship Allah on the edge of a cliff, on the edge. If good happens, they're grateful. But if a calamity befalls upon them, a trial, a test, they fall back on their face. They lose this life and the hereafter. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the most loved action to Allah is what is constant, even though it's little. Respected brothers, do you know why the shuyukh and the du'at are always in the masjid? Because they fear that they might go astray. By Allah, whether he's a shaykh or a alim or a student of knowledge, if he does not come to the masjid, know that he's on the path of error. It doesn't matter how long the beard is. Your respected brother here at the moment, if he doesn't come to the masjid and strengthen his faith and connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will go astray. I need the house of Allah. I need to be in congregation. I need to connect with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This sahabi radiallahu ta'ala an, he was inside the masjid in the morning at a time where it wasn't due for prayer. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked in. He said, what are you doing here, Abu Umama? He said, ya Rasulullah, worries that has overburdened me and loads that I'm finding difficulties to repay. Where did he go? Did he go to a psychologist or a psychiatrist? Did he go to the pub? Did he go to take drugs? Did he go to his mates and sit down and play cards? Where did Abu Umama go when he was in a state of difficulties? He went to the house of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught Abu Umama to make this dua, this supplication, and he said, say it in the morning and say it in the evening, which is basically asking Allah's protection from the worries and from loans, from being lazy, as many of the young brothers, they can't be bothered. They're on the dole. Get up and work. And that's the main reason that many of us taking drugs and doing the wrong thing and watching porn, because we have too much time. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most loved people to Allah are those who are most beneficial to people. We don't want Muslims to be on the dole. Get up and work and be beneficial for yourself and the community. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection from being lazy. Muslims are not lazy. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught him to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect him from the oppression of men and the difficulties of loans, and to ask Allah to protect him from fear. Aba Umama, when he did this dua, he said, by Allah, by the time the evening came, I was able to pay my loan and I have no worries. Ikhwan al-Kiram, many of us make dua, but there's a lot of difference between the person that makes dua from their hearts and with certainty, and those who make dua just by from their lips. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make dua to Allah and you have certainty that Allah is gonna respond. Make dua from your heart before your lips and Allah would respond. A companion came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, ya Rasulullah, make supplication, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah accepts my dua when I ask him. What did the Prophet say? He said, make sure that your income is halal, your wage, your salary is halal, Allah would respond to your dua. Naam ayyuhal ikhwan. We must observe what we eat and what we drink. That could be the major obstacle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not responding to our dua. Respected brothers, how can we reach that level that some of the Sahaba reached, inshallah? First of all, al-Imanu billah. First of all, we must believe in Allah in everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. Al-amr al-thani, al-majalis al-dhikr ayyuha al-shabab. The second thing is making sure that we gather. We come to gathering where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is remembered. It is so crucial. Al-amr al-thalith, al-suhba al-saliha, ya shabab. Al-suhba al-saliha. The third thing is accompanying good people. Respected brother, you have a girlfriend, you're drinking alcohol. Respected brother, you're taking drugs. Respected brother, you're disobedient to your parents. If you are serious about repenting, the first thing that I want you to do is keep away from your influential friends who are influencing you to do the wrong thing. So respected brother, if you're serious about abstaining from haram, leave your bad friends. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only accompany a believer. He didn't say Muslim. We know what some of the Muslims are doing. The biggest gang leaders, the biggest drug dealers are Muslim, Muhammad, Mahmoud, Khalid. So the Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only accompany a believer. Respected brothers, I'm begging you for the sake of Allah, accompany righteous people, because you are depending on whom you associate with. Al-mar'u ala deeni khaleelih, falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person is on the religion of his companion. Then observe who you accompany. Please, I want you to always remember this hadith. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, المؤمن القوي خير أحب إلى الله من المضعف وفي كل خير. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the strong believer is better and more love to Allah than the weak believer, and in both is good. And then he gives us the keys how to be strong and tough. And we're talking about to be strong financially, physically, faithfully. The Prophet has said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, احرص على ما ينفعك. That's the first key. Concern yourself with what benefits you. واستعين بالله. Ask Allah for help. Oh Allah, help me, ya Rabb. Oh Allah, please strengthen me. Oh Allah, distant evil away from me. Oh Allah, you know, help me to overcome these drugs and this. Ask Him, speak to Him. Allah loves when you speak to Him. Wasta'in billah. And then He said, don't despair. Don't give up. Yesterday I was counseling a brother. Every time I tell him to look up and to look forward and to progress forward, he would say, what I did previously. The Prophet has said, and don't say, if I did this, this would have happened, and if I did this, this would have happened. The Prophet has said, don't say lo, don't say if, because if opens the door of shaitan, and just say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has preordained this, and that is it. Don't say what I've done before, no, don't do that. Remember the four keys, and by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will, you'll recover from any addiction that you face.